Buongiorno everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Noura and today we are talking again about fragrances, and today I am going to tell you all about Idole from Lancome. I have here the original and the intense version, so if you were interested in buying one or another, or maybe both, then keep on watching. So let's start with the original one. I have both. I have the original here and the intense version here. I am wearing it now for about an hour. And yeah, so definitely now it is in the dry down phase. So the original one was launched last year. Behind this perfume are three women perfumers. And all the marketing is around women empowerment. I mean, you get this vibe now in the fragrance world about women empowerment. If you think about Libre by YSL, it has the same message. You have in this year the new fragrance from Armani, My Way, or are like having one or another and women empowerment message behind them. The interesting thing about this fragrance, I think, as I don't know if every ingredient, but at least a lot of the ingredients or the notes in this fragrance are sustainably sourced, which is also like a big plus. But let's talk about the fragrance itself. Okay, this is a gorgeous rose, slightly fruity scent. So you get the rose from the beginning till the dry down. Yeah, the rose persists in this fragrance. So if you are not a rose lover, this is not for you. It's not a grandma rose, in my opinion. I know that many people say it reminds them of the grandma scent. In my opinion, it's not an old-fashioned scent. Also, many people said about it that it's nothing new, it's generic. Yeah, it could be. But if you are, like me, someone who likes florals in general, I think you will love this one. It is a very unique rose in my opinion. So in the opening you get this over dose of rose, which in the dry down fades a little bit, not too much, and it has also this a little bit of a sweetie, like a fruity sweet scent. In the dry down, you get it also in the opening, but it's more prominent in the dry down. So here I have the notes. I will read it for you. So you have pear and bergamot. In the middle note, you have two types of flower of roses. You have Turkish rose and rose de mai and Indian jasmine. I don't get the jasmine very much in this scent. It's much more like a rosy scent. In the base note you have white musk and vanilla, which gives us this like, with it, along with the pear, gives it this like a little bit sweetness, but not too much, because I personally dislike sweet fragrances, and this is exactly my type of sweetness. It's very subtle, it's fruity, it's actually, in my opinion, exactly how a fruity floral scent should be. If we talk about performance, it has on my skin an average performance. Sillage, it definitely leaves a beautiful sillage behind, which remains for a while. Maybe after an hour you have to be like sitting beside the person who wears this perfume to get it, but definitely on the sillage it has a very nice sillage. Not too much, because I am a person who doesn't like to overwhelm people with my perfume, So it is exactly what I like. So this is why I think this is the only perfume I ever bought full price. So who can wear this scent? I find this scent very pretty much universal. So I think everyone at any age can wear this perfume. And I think it's a mass pleasing scent. This is maybe why many people say it's generic. But you will find, if you follow my channel, you will find that I love a lot of generic perfumes. But I mean, I don't mind. And yeah, I do recommend it if you are a rose lover. If you don't like rose, don't buy this fragrance. So this is the original one. This year, actually a month ago, I think, they came out, or 2 months ago, they came out with Idole L'Intense, which is the intense version. It has the same bottle, this is also the 25, the only difference, it has like a rose gold sheen to it. So let's talk about L'Intense. The opening of this perfume is just gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. It's sweeter and the roses are not so prominent in this perfume like in the original one. Instead, they went for jasmine. And I love jasmine, so I was very happy about it. It has a little bit of a fresh sweet opening. In the dry down, you get this jasmine woody scent. So instead of a fruity floral, you have now a woody floral, in my opinion. So here I have the nose. Okay, the top notes are bitter orange and mandarin oranges, which gives it this like zesty, not zesty, but this fresh opening that I personally love. In the middle note, you have Turkish rose, grass rose, or grass, I don't know how to pronounce this. It's this a famous city in France where they produce perfume. Then you have three kinds of jasmine. You have Egyptian jasmine, jasmine sambac, jasmine, and musk. In the base, you get a whole different vibe. So you have acacia, cashmere, wood, patchouli, vanilla, cedar, and sandalwood. This is why I say it's a woody fragrance in the dry down, which the original one is not. So if you like rose, you will go for the original one. If you like jasmine, go for the intense one. It's really heavy on the jasmine. So, and it becomes more intense, more deep in the dry down. It persists longer than the original, which you would like expect from an intense version. So it lasts longer, but I can't describe it as a long-lasting perfume. It's just average. Maybe a little bit more than average, but definitely in performance, it's like good fragrances from the same category. This perfume is not for any occasion as the first one. The first one is a pretty floral that you can wear during autumn, so like spring, also winter if you like it. This one is more woody, and for that it goes more for winter, so it's more autumn winter. A little bit difficult. I wouldn't wear this fragrance during spring and summer because it's too much, it's too heavy. So if you have the original one and you are wondering if the intense one is different or better, or if you should buy it, in my opinion, they are different. So it's not like the same. This is like a fruity floral heavy on rose, this is a woody floral heavy on jasmine. Both are stunning in my opinion, I love them both. The only thing I have also to mention about the intense version is on the skin, at least on my skin, it becomes a very a nice sweet jasmine, but on my clothes the dirty jasmine becomes very prominent. So I never spray this on my clothes because I don't like this heavy dose of dirty jasmine. I always spray this on my skin, never on my clothes. But again, these are preferences, so you can choose what you like, you can test it around. So this is everything about Idole Original and Idole L'Intense. I hope you like this video and I hope it was helpful. And if you like this video, please consider giving it a thumb up and subscribe to my channel, and see you next time. Ciao!